So basically now let's look into currency market. Okay, so if you guys watch the commodity, all commodity prices, price fluctuation, you'll have a lot of doubts. So make sure to know, make a note of it, and then when we do the live trading session, I'll take each and every query over there. Okay, matlab whatever you try trading or any kind of. Okay, so now let's talk into currency market. Now what happens in the currency market? Currency is exchanged in different parts of the world. Like for example, I go to Singapore, I can give INR there and I can take Singapore dollar or I can take USD. In a similar way, an American comes to India, he will be giving dollar and he will be taking INR. So because of this reason, there is no permanent or a fixed market for currency market. It is mainly exchanged via banks and tellers. So basically, whenever the banks are exchanging one currency with another currency, they keep a record of it. And that basically, those data is shared with each other. And the data, what we get from that is basically called as a OTC market. So for example, right now, let us look into how an OTC market works. OTC stands for over-the-counter market. So here an Indian student goes to ICICI Bank and says, I want dollar. So ICICI Bank will tell him, okay, give me 68 rupees, 98 paisa. I'll give you $1. Now, how does ICICI Bank get this money? ICICI Bank will put this request asking other banks if they want INR and in return they can give dollar. At that same time, Burger King, let's say an American company which wants to open an outlet in India, will ask Bank of America to basically So basically Bank of America at that point of time will tell that, look, we want 68 rupees for every $1 which we will give you. Give us 68.99. So like in the equity market, ICICI Bank is on behalf of Indian student asking 68.98 and Bank of America is demanding 68.99. So there is a spread of 1 paisa. So like this, after half an hour, Reliance will come and say, we want dollar and we are willing to give 68.96. But that time, the Development Bank of Singapore may say, no, we want 70 rupees for every $1. Who is giving this dollar? Samsung. Where did the Samsung get the dollar? Samsung has sold some product in US market, collected the dollar. That dollar is lying with the Development Bank of Singapore. Now that dollar, they want to convert it into INR because Samsung is planning to set up a factory in India. So basically Samsung is asking for INR. Now, why Reliance wants dollar? Because they have imported some oil from other country for which they have to make the dollar payment and they are trying to buy it at 68.96. So like this, every minute there would be different trades going in the market. Wherever it is available at a low cost, people would be rushing into that market. As a result, the prices across the market, Singapore, Dubai, or Hong Kong or London, the prices will be almost equal for the currency. Now, using this data, we basically trade in the futures market. Okay, any question? How the prices are determined? One second, I'll unmute. Future. Any doubt? did you get how the currency prices keep fluctuating?
Yes, yes.
Like for example, if lot of investors are rushing, saying that we will invest dollar in India. So that time Indian banks can offer them lesser quantity of rupee. They can tell, I'll give you 68, I'll give you 67. Like that Indian banks will have the bargaining power. But if the same foreign investors who have invested in India, if they want to pull out the money from India, they will tell, take the INR, give us whatever dollar you can give, and they will compete with the Indian banks. As a result, to buy $1, we have to give higher quantity of Indian rupee. Whenever we give a higher quantity of Indian rupee, we call our currency is depreciating. because we have to give more quantity of INR to buy a foreign currency, that is mainly the dollar. But if we are giving lesser quantity of rupee and getting a foreign dollar, we call it as INR appreciating. So currently what is happening? Are foreigners coming and pumping the money in India, or they're taking out the money?
Taking out.
So what the FIIs are doing is they're selling the shares. When they sell the share, exchange will give them INR. That INR, they will ask the bank to convert it into dollar. So foreign institutional investors are also asking for a dollar. Indian banks are also asking for the dollar. As a result, there is a more demand for the dollar and higher supply of rupee. So rupee from 70 to 50 has gone to 75, 62. Like it has appreciated, rupee has depreciated by almost by 3 rupees. Now it could have even gone to 80 rupees, but only good thing that happened. That is Reliance, Essar Oil, ONGC, they are asking for lesser quantity of dollar. Why? Any guesses? If earlier they were asking $40, now they are asking only $23.
Cheaper oil
price.
The crude oil price and the base metal prices have come down, right? Because of that, the demand for the dollar has gone down. Because of that, the rupee is stabilizing at 75, 62. Otherwise, it would have gone to something like around 80, 85 by now. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So this is a 24/7 market. RBI will be taking the rate, average rate from this market, and it will publish a rate. That rate is called RBI reference rate. Now, there is no guarantee that you can go and buy dollar at that rate, because when RBI declares this day rate, it would be morning 11:15 and 2 o'clock everyone wants to buy dollar. So at that time you may not get the dollar at the rate what RBI has published. Whatever the rate RBI has published, you will not be able to get it. So this market keeps on changing every second. So what we do, we take the rate from this market and we basically predict, we basically make a deal in the futures market. And that market in India, we call it as currency derivatives market. Yeah, any question on this part? How the prices are determined? Okay, so
I joined 3 minutes late, sir.
Okay, good. USD INR, currently in the futures market, what happens in the spot market? 75.65. Currency market 75.65. Okay. So there would be a bidder here. And there would be a seller. He is asking 75.66. Okay, this is, let's say we'll take March futures. This is April futures. Now in futures, what happens? You have to buy mark minimum. There will be a minimum quantity that you have to buy. Market lot. So market lot here is you have to buy minimum $1,000. Minimum you have to buy $1,000. Okay, $1,000 you have to buy. For this, you have to pay a margin of 2,500. Now, how do we know the margin? Quadratilunder.
Huh. Zero the margin calculator.
Zero the margin calculator. So we'll go to zero the margin calculator. Otherwise, if you want everything in single sheet, you can go to Trade Genie currency derivatives margin. Trade Genie currency derivatives margin. Oops. Okay, so here you can see for USD INR, you have to pay 2,073 rupees as a margin. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 2,073. Lot size is 1,000. Now, what I do, I pay a margin of 2,100 and I can go and buy or sell. So should I buy or should I sell?
Go to the chart.
Okay, so basically let's go to the USD INR chart. USD INR chart. Say, what is the chart telling you? Up or down?
Up.
See here, 7485. This is a 1 minute chart. Okay. I'll put it to our chart. See. So, down, down. Tested all the bottoms here. Then it basically broke out. Correct? It just broke out. So here at 7260. Okay, that was a point where you could have gone long. 7260. It just shot up. Seventy to sixty, you could have gone long, and today you can sell it at 72.24. This rate you can sell it. Like, let us look at last hourly basis. On hourly basis, see here. This was a straight away gap up opening. Usually, when the gap up opening happens, don't buy at the gap up. Wait for the price to cool down, and then you attend somewhere when the 2-3 candles create a bottom at the same level. That means someone is accumulating. So you could have bought it here at 74.93. You could have bought it and sold it at 74.23, 24. So here 74.93 buy, 74.93 this guy would have sold, and then you could have gone and sold it at 75.24. Look, I'll just take the buy rate here. Okay, bid ask chhod dete hain. Buy here and sell here. So how much you made? You made a neat profit of 31 paise. Now 31 paise into 1,310 rupees, you made a profit. What is the investment required? 2,100. So 310 divided by 2,100. 14% return in a day. Aur kya chahiye?
So this margin is the same across the brokers, right?
Across the brokers. If you put MIS order, it will be lesser. 1,800 margin.
Sir, why we are taking USD INR? We can take USD something else also, no? Or AUD or
in USD. India, friends, in India you have only four currencies. Which are those? USD INR. USD INR Euro. Sorry, Euro INR.
Pound and
pound. See here, in India you have these pairs: USD INR, JPY INR, GBP INR, Euro INR. That's it.
Sir, you told it is
So USD INR, why I like here, the relationship directly happens between the buyer and seller. Are you getting my point? Because the buyer wants the dollar, thinks that dollar will become more stronger. That means going forward, for the same dollar, he can get more quantity of INR. Today, if I'm buying $1, how much quantity INR am I giving him? Today, if I'm buying $1, like Monday morning, 75.62. So for $1, I will have to pay 7265 INR. 7562 INR for every $1. What is my logic? My logic is that after 3 weeks, people will give me for every $1 something like 7621. That's my logic. So today, if I take 75,620 from my account, I'll get how much dollars? $1,000. And the same dollar, $1,000, after 3 weeks, if I go to the market, someone will give me 76,210. So what happened? My capital appreciated by 590. Now, do I have to pay full 75,622 by $1,000?
No, margin only have to pay 2,100.
Margin 2,100. That's it. I have to pay. So on 2,100, if I get this 590, it's almost around 25% return.
But I have to do MIS or I have to do.
After 3 weeks means which one you have to do?
CNC.
CNC, normal. NRML. You have to put
NRML.
NRML, load order. MIS only for intraday.
So 14% return which you are showing, that is MIS.
MIS. Because where the appreciation happened in one day.
So tell me one thing, if I do NRML, okay, even then I can sell in the same day, right?
Yeah.
But I have to pay only the margin only. In MIS also, I have to pay the margin only.
Exactly.
So it is always better to do NRML only, no?
And better.
Because you don't know, even if something goes wrong, you just keep
carry your position. You can carry a position for the next day. MIS is only for those people who don't have full money.
But in this case, anyways, you play margin only.
Correct. That way you start with NRML. That would be good.
For both intraday and for carrying forward, you have to only play margin.
Exactly, sir. 2,100.
So when you're paying only 2,100, it doesn't matter whether you're doing MIS or NRML. It is always better you do NRML.
Exactly. Because
you can at least carry your position.
But everyone will not have 2,100, no?
Okay.
You're talking from your point of view. But what about others like me who have only 1,800?
So 2,100 into 4,000 shares. 4,000
lots. 1,000 lot, not 1,000 lots, one lot. In one lot, you have $1,000.
Right.
So if you have 21,000, you can buy it 10 lots.
Okay.
I'll show the same trade for 10 lots, how it would work. 74.94 you bought. Okay. And you sold it at 75.24. Okay. So here you would have made a profit of this minus this. 30 paisa, you made a profit. Okay. 30 paisa for $1. Into $1,000, you will make 300. Now, if you into 10 lots, you make a profit of 3,000.
So 21,000 rupees, you will get 3,000 rupees.
Exactly.
And what is the probability of downside?
Downside, basically, if it goes down, you have to pay the losses.
Okay.
Recently, I had done one trade. I'll show you that trade. I had for some event, I had taken it. Let me show you. Yeah. Can you see the PPT here? Yeah, this one. See, USD INR. What I did, I bought at 72.59. This is my account. 72.59 I bought. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
And I sold it at a rate of 73.50, 73.70 and all I sold. So I had around 5 lots. 5 lots in a sense, 5,000.
Right.
So basically,
margin will be different
around for 10,000 rupees.
So around 7,000 rupees, I made a profit there.
So you invested around 10,000 rupees.
Huh? Around 10,000. Because that was a good breakout. 100% I was sure it will break out. I'll tell you, because it was like, see, it was a triangle shape was there.
So in a day?
In 2 days. It just the whole thing happened in 2 days. In one day, basically, I do around 3,000, 4,000, sometimes loss of 4,000. So loss bhi hota hai, profit bhi hota hai. It's not like it's a one way.
Yeah.
Got it. So it's a, but only one problem is it will kill all your time. You'll not be able to do any other work. Because this currency market, currency market, you will not know when the breakout will happen. Let me be honest.
What's the timing, sir?
Currency market timing is morning 9 o'clock to evening 5 o'clock.
9 to 5.
So see here, when the 70 to 50 got broke out here, somewhere here. 70 to 50 to see here. See this breakout. If you put in daily, you'll see that. Triangle breakout, huh? Sorry, channel. It was like a kind of a channel. See? Made a high. Finally, it broke out here. So I entered somewhere here around 70 to 50. And then it went to this level, 73.70 or something. I'd exited. And then it again came back to the same level, went up, now gap up. So I think I'll not be surprised even if it goes to 78.
Why 78, sir?
Because it's people are buying dollar.
But you told 78 exactly, sir. So I thought there is no previous history also.
History also, sir, but at least yahan se aur ek matlab 3 rupees upset.
You do only the March future, not April and May.
You can make that. March also you can do it.
But how do you choose normally?
Current March month you choose. Okay. You tell me why I should do March. I'll choose April also and show you. USD, INR.
Volatility will be more.
Huh?
Volatility will be more in March.
No, look at the price. What's the difference between April and April? See here, which is better? April is better or March is better?
March.
Why April is bad?
Higher price.
Longer the future contract, higher will be the price. Because the seller will charge you interest, na? Clear, Siddharth? Siddharth, na?
Clear.
So basically, you have to put on this screen chart and you have to keep watching it. Now do one thing. If you are bullish, instead of buying futures, buy call option. I think Deepika wanted to try options. So what you do, ma'am? Buy 76 call option. 76 call option. You just have to invest 13 paise. That's it.
Only 13 paise
into 1,000.
Anesh will buy all the call options.
Huh? but that if you are blindly believing me, thinking that it will go up, but yeah, 70. You should have bought it on Friday. Monday it will be at a higher rate because already last night the gap up happened. Na? So 76 ka March ka call option. If you see here, USD INR. 76 March call option. Yeah, so basically what you could have done Friday, you could have bought it at 13 paise. It will go to 22 paise Friday morning. Sorry, Monday morning. You can sell it. Why it will go to 22 paise?
22. Gap up.
Delta.
Okay.
You forgot delta. Whenever the underlying share price goes. Whenever the share price increases, then basically the call option premium will drastically increase. So you can just buy. Now, Madhipika ji, what is the capital required to buy this?
I think
13 paisa into
1,130 135.
Correct. So start with it. But anyone of you feel that it will go down to 74 from the current level?
No.
It has gone to record high, sir. So maybe if it breaks 4.9.
Okay, so you're saying
after,
that
after giving 135, how much will you win? How much will you gain?
That you tell me after buying call option. When do you make money? Siddharth, you tell me.
Might be 1-2 paisa you'll gain.
Call option ka, when do you get profit, Siddharth, in call option?
When the price goes above the strike price.
Siddharth ji, what? You forgot all the basics. When the market, if Deepika's luck is good, I mean, it will be good. If it goes to 78, how much will she get back?
2,000.
She will get 2 rupees back. 13 paisa investment, 2 rupees back. Into 1,000, she will get 2,000 back.
So it's better to trade in option only, no, sir? Currency?
Yes. Yes. Anish, one advice for you, focus on either one of the commodity or one of the currency or Nifty. Looks like you're going to try everything. As a trader, it will not be possible here to trade everything. Your mind will get completely diluted. Just for
what
one or
do?
Two. For me, I only do training. jokes apart, usually I trade only in stocks. I trade in Reliance, Infi and Titan. Okay, selected stocks I trade. And then currency I trade only USD INR I trade. And then these days I trade much of a gold. Crude oil I have cut down. Okay, so basically what you do, 76 ka call option, buy it at 13 paise.
And options, all you are doing options only.
Which one? Me?
This Reliance, Infi, Titan, Gold, USD, and all options.
All that I do, mix karte hai, sir. Kabhi kabhi futures, sometimes options. It depends based on the market condition. Okay. See, now basically we are only looking at short side. We are not looking at long side.
Okay.
Titan and Gold, we are purely looking at short side. Okay, so let's not deviate. So let's come back. So are you all getting an idea how this thing works? So basically, if you buy March futures contract at 75.24, it closes at 75.62, right? This one, yeah. You buy here at 74.94, and if you sell it here at 76, in futures, you'll get 1 rupee 6 paisa. Instead, you could have done one thing. USD INR, you could have got 75 ka call option. You just had to pay around 28 paisa. And currently, USD INR has gone to 70s. Assuming it closes at 76, you'll get 1 rupee here. You can do intraday also in options.
Sir, in intraday, when doing intraday also, it should go beyond our margin.
Not necessary. Delta will come in. Delta will come in. Whenever the share price goes up, the option premium will increase. Because whenever the share price increases, the currency, whenever the underlying asset price increases, the premium will also sharply increase.
Yes.
I'll show you the chart. See here. This is USD INR 75 call option. Okay. It was trading around 36 paise, then went to 70 paise, came to 29 paise, went to 24 paise. On hourly basis, you see. See, it was around 4 paise, March 4th. It was trading at 4 paise.
Yeah.
From 4, it went to 21, and then 29, then 50, then 14, 26, 59, 33, now 45. So you could have taken a bet on that.
we could have even like used that adding positions once the price starts moving in our favor. So.
Yeah.
No, it is about intraday, no? Now, what you are speaking is about intraday, right?
We are talking about see, look at the date, sir. It's given on the chart below date, na? What is the date that is given there? Fourth March, sir. It was 22 paise. From there, down, up, down. So currently 45. So if the currency closes somewhere around 75-60, this 45 paise will now become 60 paise.
So normally, for when you talk us about options, we did not go to the options chart. We used to go to the underlying main chart. Like Infosys, if you're looking at options, you're looking at Infosys main chart, right?
Mm-hmm.
For USD INR, is there any chart like that, or we'll have to go and see the C or PE chart?
No. Look at the underlying asset. Go to first. What you do? You go to USD INR March futures. Okay. So basically, March futures ka you put the chart. And look at the hourly chart. When the breakout happens, then you basically buy it.
Okay.
See, now the breakout is happening, na? Breakout happened here already. You're late. 74.60 ke upar was a good buy. Usse acha better was 72.30-50.
Currency is only USD is better to trade.
No, I'll tell you about other currencies. This all of you got an idea? Now, for example, if someone feels it will go down to 74. Now, in India, if they invent a vaccination for Corona, then USD INR may come down to 73-74. So basically what you can do, you can buy 75 ka put option. USD INR March 75 put. So 75 put, it is 22 paisa. So people who sold this put option, they would have made a fortune. So it was trading around 2 rupees 55 paisa. From there it has come to 25. So when you are confident USD INR is going to become weaker, you could have sold this put option. You would have collected 3 rupees and now you can buy back at 22 paisa. So you can buy it at 22 paisa if you think the prices of USD INR will come down. But I don't think so it's going to come down. So buying this would be not that worth. Yes, any questions? Sir, any questions on USD INR trading? No, can I proceed further?
Yes.
Yeah. All of you are comfortable, na? But I think when you put your order, na, like when you click buy button in your Zerodha account, it will get rejected. It will tell kindly activate your USD INR currency derivative segment. So you have to send a request for activation. If your order goes through, nothing like it.
So call your put again. When the market is going up, then it is call, right?
Yes.
Means I have to buy call.
Yes.
When the market is going down, I have to buy put.
Yes. Yeah. So no questions on USD INR? All of you are clear?
Yes, sir.
On doing intraday trading, just try to capture around 15 paisa to 18 paisa. Because you can't expect 1 rupee movement in currency market every day. So if you put a 5-minute chart, here, USD INR March, see, so this breakout was there, 71.12. So this was a good level for me to enter and I exited 71.23. So I just capture around 9 paisa. Now you may ask, 9 paisa, is it profitable? Yes, it is profitable. What you can do, 75.12 you buy. sell at 75.24. Okay, so yeah, if for one lot you are making around 23. For one lot you are making around 90 rupees because your brokerage is 15, and other taxes everything deducted. Total cost comes around 19.
Okay, this 20. Is futures, right?
Yeah.
This
is for futures. For 10 lot, you will make around 1035. So just try to capture 12 paisa in a day, make around 1000. Once you're comfortable, increase your lot size to 100. Now to buy 100 lots, all you require capital is 180,000. Okay, no doubts?
Sir, two questions I have. Intraday means till 5 p.m., right?
Yes, exactly.
After 5 p.m., what will happen if I don't square off?
They will, broker will square off, even if you don't square off.
So broker will square up and they'll give me what? Dollars.
If you have profit, they'll give you profit, or if you have loss, they'll give you loss.
Okay.
Well, first of all, you are not getting, on what currency are you betting, sir?
USD-INR.
USD-INR. So basically in what, for $1, you're charging how much? 75.12 you're buying, correct?
Right.
And you're selling at 75.23. So basically, right, you buy a dollar at 75.12. Like, okay, this many of them get confused here. Ram will buy $1 and he will pay 75.12. And then Ram will buy. Then he will sell. At 75.23, he will receive. So how much did he pay here? 75.12. How much did he receive? 75.23. So basically, the difference 11 paisa into the lot size. Assuming he had done a trade for $10,000, 1,100 rupees will be given to him.
Right, sir. Now the same thing in options.
Hmm.
What will happen at the end of the day if I don't square up?
You don't square off, huh?
No, if I don't square off, or if I forget to square off, or what will happen?
Can you repeat the question? I didn't get your question.
I bought call option.
You bought call option. What's the strike rate?
75.12.
75. Huh? What's the strike rate?
30 paisa.
Okay, 75 strike rate, you bought it at 30 paisa. Agreed. So you pay 30 paisa.
Right.
Then did you sell it?
I did not sell it.
Oh, your broker, did the broker sell it?
Of course, the broker will sell it, no, by the end of the day.
Okay, so broker sell it. At what rate did he sell it?
Say 75.23.
No, premium.
Premium, if the premium...
You paid 30 premium, paisa. You paid 30 paisa.
32 paisa.
Okay, he sold it for 32 paisa.
So how much is it? 200 rupees.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, you told us that the timing is from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. What is the time when it is most active? Like you tell...
Full day. I told you, whole day, anytime it can break out. Usually, like most of the day, it will be moving sideways. But suddenly, there will be huge buying coming from this foreign institutional investors, banks, exporters at any point of time. So that time the momentum happens. So whole day you have to watch the chart.
Okay.
There's no fixed timing. And don't buy huge quantity and carry your position for the next day, because there is always gap up and gap down.
Okay.
For example, your bad luck. You bought this dollar at 75.12. Okay. You did not sell it. Next day morning, it went down to 74. So that time you will receive 74. So straight away, you will have a loss of 1 rupee 12 paisa. Into how much?
Whatever, 1000.
Into 1000. If you have $10,000 into 10,000, you will have a loss. Something wrong.
Into 10.
Into 10,000. You have 11,200 rupees ka loss. So that's the reason when you're carrying overnight position, carry smaller quantity or buy a futures and buy a put option to hedge it.
But when we take, with the time frame when we take it also, it gets counted, sir.
Yes, sir.
Like if you're like when it broke out at 72,
mm-hmm.
if you had bought means, like, then we can take an overnight.
Then you can do it. But now the market is very volatile, na? Like 75, 62 you buy. Suddenly some positive news comes. Like when I say positive news, 75, 64 you buy. And suddenly they say, fine, they no need to lock down the country. We have vaccination. It will next day morning open at 73, 85.
Oh.
That time 17,000 rupees, boom, gone. So better is you buy call option. Because in call option, what is your maximum loss?
The premium.
Buy 76 ka call option at 30 paise. Next day it comes to 74. That will become zero. You will just lose 3,000 rupees.
For overnight, options are better. For intraday, futures are better.
Perfectly. For intraday, buy futures. You can even do it for intraday few options also. But I prefer futures because wahan pe you get the actual difference. Because in options, you remember, na? The option premium will not change in the same amount what the share price changes because of the delta. So, yahan pe intraday ke liye use futures. For carrying the carry forward positions, use options. I think some of the participants are missing. Sukumar is there?
I am there, sir. No problem.
You are not asking any question. How come? This is good for housewives, people retired, people or people like me who don't have any work to do. So now all the trainings have been cancelled. Na? So we sit and watch the chart. And whenever we get a breakout, we buy and sell. Now the all markets have become volatile. You don't have to just focus on currency market. So you can actually scalp it. Okay, so clear with this concept, USDINR, all of you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so do one lot tomorrow. Just first get your account activated, do one lot, because maximum agar rupee 50 paisa bhi change hota, you lose only 500 on futures. So do one lot and see how your luck works. But properly watch the chart. There is a good website where you get historical chart. It is called Trading View. Go to tradingview.com. They actually take the rate from the spot market rate. So the rate will be lesser than the futures rate, but the price movement will almost be same. Achha, they've started giving chart for COVID also. Okay. Now you can see here USD INR. So USD INR, you do one thing, take IC. IC is intercontinental rate. Okay, don't go for ONDA, go for intercontinental. No. What happened here?
Can you paste it in the chat?
Yeah, I'll paste it. One second, I'll just open the USD INR chart.
IO, sir?
USD INR, go for that ICE. Okay, see, broke out here 7207, went up 7453, acted like a resistance but couldn't hold out. So when 7480-50 got broken out, that was a good entry point for you. Now though it is just an upside, it's an all-time high. So shorting is very risky. Don't do shorting by any chance. Okay. So look at going long. So even if it comes back to 7453, people will try to grab it.
Sir, we should use TradingView or investing.com?
TradingView ka currency charts are more updated.
Okay.
Because they give you IC chart.
We can save our recent and this.
Yeah.
You can save it.
Yeah, you can save it. Clear, sir? So you can use this chat. I'll put that in the chat. Okay, so watch this chart every day. Now that it's only long. No, there's no short ink. Okay. Now let me go to Euro INR.
Wash it again.
Okay, so in Euro INR, Euro dollar, this is Euro USD. Okay, so Euro USD, what do you think? Friends? Okay, I'll just. So Euro USD, do you think it will go? You guys are a bit late. Euro USD day before yesterday was a good shorting opportunity. See,
sir, why is it 1.1?
Hmm?
This is at 1.06. This.
No. If you look at the monthly chart, weekly chart.
Sir, the link which you pasted now, that is for registering Apple. I don't know.
Check USD INR there. Just type USD INR.
Okay.
So here, if you see, 1.09, this was a very strong support. Okay, see, tested many times. Finally, it broke. So, now though, it looks very weak. Euro, 1.06, na? So it can come all the way down to
1.05.
I think it can come down even up to those levels, something like 0.99. Okay, this now 1.03. The immediate target is 1.03, but I won't be surprised even if it comes to 0.90.
So here also you have taken ICE, right?
ICE. Okay, now can someone tell me? Why are we looking Euro USD chart? In India, you can't trade Euro USD. You can trade only Euro INR. But matlab, actively traded pair is that. But why are we looking into Euro USD? Because India, what happens if I go and ask, give me Euro against INR? Like if I say, give me 1 euro against INR, he will tell for every euro. He has to give me what is the quote for in INR, right? So what most of the they do is they check what is the price of Euro USD. Now 1 euro against USD is currently costing 1.06. So what is the value of 1 USD in India? 75.64, correct? 75.64. So if I give 75.64, how much I'll get? I'll get 1 euro, 1 USD. I'll get 1 USD. Yes. Now how much USD I want to buy 1 euro? I need 1.06. Correct? Based yes, on the chart. So I have to pay 80 rupees to get 1 euro. Now tomorrow, if the euro USD remains at 75.64 and if the euro goes to 0.090, then I can buy just by paying 68 rupees. Something is wrong. Oh, correct. Yes, I can buy 1 euro at 68.07.
So this is the reason you were saying that there is no direct relationship. There is direct relationship between USD and INR, but yes, there is no direct relationship.
Exactly, you got it right. Are you all? You want me to explain the cross multiplication, friends? Now for buying one others for others, so Anish, for buying 1 euro, I have to pay 1.09 USD. Okay. But going forward, I can buy the same euro at 1 point. I can buy the same euro at 0.9. I can buy the euro at 0.9 USD. Now to buy 0.9 USD, I just have to shell out 68.76. So I can get 1 euro at a rate of 68. So what should I do? Should I buy euro now or sell euro now? So I will sell April euro today at 80 rupees. And if the Europe hits a recession, euro is going to go down to 0.09 against a dollar. That time, in India, euro will be trading at 68. You make a killing out of it. Any what questions? 1000. So same thing you can see here. Euro INR chart. Euro INR chart. Okay. It had gone to 92, 84. Now 80. So on a daily basis chart, if you see, you can see weakness. So ideally wait for this level to be broken, 77 to be broken. So if 77 is broken, then we are heading towards 68 historical support. So below 76 you can short it. Blindly you can short it. Below 76. You want an early start? You can short it now. Below 80. For a first target of 76. Once 76 is broken, then it can go down to 68.
We can do options.
Options are very illiquid, sir. Very illiquid. You can't find... There are, like, for example, euro, INR, April, okay, April 79 put. It is there, but no buyer, no seller. I can put buy at 10 paisa. Who knows? I may get it. I'll put a aim order and leave it. I will put 100, 10 lots. Okay, AMO order I can put. Buy. So let's see, if my luck is good, if someone sells it to me, then my luck is, I can, I'll be making a good money. Because my investment is what, 1000 rupees. And I'm buying 79 ka put. Even if it goes to 76, how much profit will I be making there?
3 rupees.
That too, I have time till April. Okay, any questions? No. Feel free. So, are you all able to get the currency concepts easily?
Yes, sir.
Now, Euro-INR making intraday trading doesn't make much sense because Euro-USD is very active post 6:30 p.m. U.S. timing. So that time our market will be closed. So you can't do much intraday trading there. Only thing you can do is positional trading in Euro INR compared to intraday trading. You can do intraday trading, but it makes more sense to do positional trading there. Because in intraday trading, you won't get much opportunity here in Euro INR.
I think intraday commodities is good.
Yeah, yeah. Intra first. Do one thing. Morning 9 o'clock, you start with Nifty. 10:30 do USD INR. Okay, post 2 o'clock you can try copper and aluminium. By 6:30 you can do gold silver.
Okay. 9 o'clock Nifty, 10:30.
And 9 o'clock you can do natural gas, but you will be completely lost. You will not even know your name. Don't ask me how much your P&L will be looking like.
Sir, you told morning 9 o'clock Nifty.
No, don't do that. Don't do that. Focus, don't do it, sir. Focus in on any particular one asset class. See, I'm comfortable with dollar, I do dollar. You guys are comfortable with Nifty, do Nifty.
It is also a question of investment. No?
Yeah, if your investment is low, do gold petal, that's it. 400 rupees is the investment for gold petal. If your investment is around 2,000-3,000, do USD INR futures. If your investment is 7,000, do silver. If your investment is more than 60,000, do Nifty. More than 1 lakh, crude oil.
So we can do also USD INR, no? That options.
You can do that. That's what, sir. I've been teaching everything. You guys are learning it. Now the question is how much practice you will do in terms of chart. End of the day, your interpretation of chart reading, that makes you as a successful trader. You have to spend most of your time looking at the chart. Look at the gold ka chart, look at the dollar ka chart, look at euro ka chart. Wherever good opportunity comes, buy it.
If we track USD, we can track even gold.
Exactly. You do only USD only. Now why you have to go to gold? Yeah. There only you can make money. Now look at this Titan ka chart and tell me what will you exactly do here. Can you do something? Can you short it?
It is in downtrend. It support the resistance.
No. Can you short it now? It's at the historical support level. You can't short. Can you go long?
No.
Then, so Titan doesn't work. Then look at crude oil. Already we saw crude oil ka chart. Now let us look at GBP USD. If any opportunity is there, GBP USD. GBP is Great British Pound and USD. You guys are again late here. In fact, for CCM 65, I told them if 1.27 is taken,
put option is good.
See, GBP. Say 1.27 is taken, correct?
Yeah. Sir, we cannot use tight charts. Tight mein jo chart aata na zero door.
But wo to bas aapko iske liye milega sir. Kiske liye? GBP. GBP equity के लिए मिलता है, GBP INR का मिलेगा, GBP USD का नहीं मिलेगा. So see here friends, sideways. Okay, so it basically broke. यहाँ पे you could have blindly gone short. Easy ना, यहाँ पे अगर आप short लेते ना, $1.27 if you had taken short, and 1.30 was your stop loss. Or you could have kept 1.32 as a stop loss. You are keeping 5 cents. How much is 1 cent value in INR? This trading you lot of trading you lot of unwanted advertisement. That's the reason I hate it. Okay, GBP USD. 1 cent is equal to how many?
70 paise.
1.27 it broke. So 70 paise. No, 1 cent is equal to 70 paise, correct?
75.
70. Okay, let's say we'll take around 75. So 5 cents. How much would 5 cents? 75 into 5. That would be equivalent to 3.75 was your stop loss. That I will buy if it goes to 1.32. That was actually next to impossible. Once this previously, 1, 2, third time broken, chances of coming back is very, very less. So keeping such a high stop loss, if we had taken mentally prepared, you could have, it came down to how much? 1.14. How many cents did you capture?
1.13.
13 cents. You captured 13 cents. So you captured 75 paisa into 13 cents. So that would be 7 rupees 50 paisa plus another 1, around 9 rupees you would have captured.
9.75.
So now tell me, does technical analysis work or not?
Yes,
with the practice. Okay. So, and you have now, you know, from me, you have got knowledge on call option, you have got knowledge on put option, commodity, currency. So basically apply on all the asset classes and try your luck. 3 rupees 75 paisa is a loss, 9 rupees is your profit.
So in investing.com will get everything, currencies.
Yeah, you get it, you get currencies, you get it. मतलब ट्रेडिंग में थोड़ा वो फीचर्स ज्यादा है, 1 मिनट वाला चार्ट सब मिलता है, बट वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट ज्यादा है उसमें, यू गेट लॉट ऑफ एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स देयर. स्टार्ट विद ट्रेडिंग व्यू, investing.com, इट इज गुड. नाउ यू गॉट द आईडिया हाउ द सिस्टम वर्क्स. सो इन इंडिया हाउ डज द प्राइस गेट ट्रेडेड? जीबीपी आईएनआर. एनी गेसेस? जीबीपी आईएनआर. जीबीपी GBP INR, basically for $1, 1 GBP, if I want to determine the price, what I should do, I have to do the same logic. One GBP USD, that is equal to 1.27, correct?
Yes.
So same cross multiplication, you can copy paste.
Sir, can you also share this Excel in the chat?
I'll have to send it through email. I'll share it. I'll save this.
But in chat also, it will be possible, no?
Chat, I don't know, sir. One second, sir. We'll complete this.
WhatsApp.
I can send it through WhatsApp. Okay, 1.27. Do it yourself, then you'll learn it.
Yeah.
See, Deepikaji. Deepikaji will do all the calculation, put it in Excel. Wherever you are getting lost, make a note of it. In live trading class, I'll take the question. Whatever the explanation, whatever the discussion we did, you start making Excel notes. Okay. Anyway, so this cross multiplication, 75.64, 1.2. So this was around 96 rupees. In India, 1 GBP was costing you 96. Okay, but let me tell you, that time our currency was not 74. It was around 74.20, I believe. It was not at 7, it was 73.85. So in India, it was around 93 rupees. 1 GBP was around 93. Today, to buy the same GBP, I just have to give 1.14. So if I want to give 1.14, current rate is 75.67. 1.14, it is 86 rupees. 1 GBP is currently 86. So let us look at the chart here in Zerodha. GBP INR March, around 88. See, from 93 was a breakout. That's a problem. In India, when the breakout happened, our market was closed. This breakout happened post 5 p.m. So at least next day morning, you still had a chance. 92 may you could have gone short. 92 may you could have gone short. Covered it around 86. Huh? Don't look at this. Look at this indicators and all. These indicators don't work here. For a simple reason, there is a gap up, gap down happening. Because Indian market is not a continuous market, na? India market closes at 5 p.m. Yeah?
We trade 24 hours in any broker from
No, bro, that it's illegal in India. 20 in India government says 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock trade currency. That's it. But they're planning to make it till night 9:30. Yeah, so these options are active only for USD INR. For Euro, GBP, if you search options, you will find options, but the premium will be very high, or there won't be any buyer seller. So options on these currencies are very limited now. Okay. Then the last pair, this also 1000 quantity. You have to trade in 1000 quantity. On one lot, you could have made 9000. Then comes JPY INR. JPY INR. So JPY INR, what should we do before we go and trade? We have to look at which chart.
JPY USD.
Yes. Look at JPY USD.
JPY is which currency?
Japanese yen. JPY stands for
yen.
Yen.
Now
we don't have anything with China.
No, thank God. Okay. Well, let's not deviate from the topic, because then we'll start making comments on China, jokes on China. So coming back to the point here, do you think JPY, will it bounce back, or is it in a downward trend?
It's not down. It's at a support.
Yeah, it's at a support.
But it can.
Come. When? The question is when. Okay. So, looking at the chart, this, once the breakout happens, then basically it can go up to this point. So, for me, in India, to buy JPY, this level has to be broken. JPY has to break this particular level. So this is.
Why did you take that high? There were many highs before that also. No,
double top. I'm looking at double top, double bottom.
Yeah, double top.
I'm looking at double bottom. So from here it should break this previous second percentage. Yeah, it should break this, and then we can look at buying it. But I don't think so. Currently, JPY may kuch potential hai kya bolke. JPY INR. You can directly look into JPY INR chart also. So for one JPY, Indian currency value should be 68. See, when this one should be good buy around 69 rupees. Currently, we are at 68. So, okay, let's look at daily. We were not looking at daily. See, daily may still, it's weak. From 73 rupees, we came down to 67, went to 66. But I think it will retest this 64. Okay, there is a small difference here. Here they are mentioning the price of one JPY against INR. But in NSE, we say for 100 JPY, how much INR I should give. Are you getting my point? In NSE, yeah, here they're quoting the price. So this was a good buy. It broke out, went up to 72. So now, according to the technical analysis, it can come down to 65 and then again go up. Again come down, and if it breaks 63, then you can look at shorting it. 63 is a good level to short for a target of 61.
If tomorrow if it gaps down, then we can go short.
But on what basis are you telling gap down will happen?
It is under
that
support.
So basically around 63 if it goes, then basically it can come down to 61. But these kind of charts are very tough now compared to USD INR. USD INR yes. Chart, it is upward. Euro, it is predictable. So focus on Euro and which is the other one, USD INR, yes. And then GBP. Last option should be JPY. If you see JPY whole the year, it has been most of the time it has been sideways. Right. Big move sideways. Now big move again sideways. So it can move sideways. So sideways mein trade karne mein koi point nahi hai. The two options are not very liquid. If the options are liquid, then you could have done strangle, sell a call, sell a put. You could have done.
You can do futures, no? Because sideways, no?
So futures, me kya karoge sideways me? What will you do in futures sideways?
Okay.
What will you do? Buy or sell?
Buy then.
Then?
I'll keep holding.
Instead, you can keep money in fixed deposit. It will give you some interest.
The return on investment
will be zero there. Okay. Any questions on currency market?
So, like,
one thing which you told is that RSI will not work in the currency market.
Yeah, because of the gap down, gap up. See here, gap.
It is only support and resistance.
Yeah, RSI and all works well when there is no gap up, gap down.
Sir, you told you want to compare the charts with international markets, right?
Uh-huh.
So Euro with USD.
Euro with USD.
And GPV
with GPV. USD. GPV USD. With USD. See what happens in international market. Okay. Banks, they will ask if I go to ICICI Bank and say give me Euro. They will not be holding Euro. So what they will do? They'll call up their friend and they'll ask, "Do you have Euro?" That guy will tell, "Give me. I'll give you Euro, but I want dollar." So then ICICI Bank will think how much dollars they have. So they will give dollars and buy Euro.
USD is the common.
Yuan is a common currency against which it is converted.
And this for USD, which one we have to see?
USD INR directly.
Direct USD INR.
Direct USD INR.
Sir, what was that? Some swap rate, something that came in the news recently?
That basically what the RBI told, na, like all this FIS and all are withdrawing money from India. So if they just everyone starts selling the INR and if they start buying dollar, INR will become very weaker. Then we'll have to pay a higher price for crude oil, pharma products and all. So what RBI told, RBI will be any point of time sitting with the dollar. What we call forex reserves.
Forex reserves.
So they told we will give you the dollar, but on a condition that after 6 months you have to give the dollar back to us.
Okay.
So you can come borrow money from us at 75 or 73, whatever is the rate which they've decided. After 6 months, give the dollar back and take the rupee.
Okay.
So that way RBI is temporarily lending money. Lending money in a sense, lending dollar. With the condition to bank that they have to give the dollar back after 6 months. So what the banks will do, instead of going to the international market, they'll go to RBI, borrow the money from dollar from them, and then basically give it to the importers like Reliance, Samsung and all of them. And after six months, when companies like Infosys and all will collect the dollar from their clients,
yes, sir.
That dollar they will take from Infosys, give it to RBI. And whatever the rupee RBI will give it to them, 73 or 74, that they will give it to Infosys. Now, this will work if this corona is temporary. If the corona is not temporary, it may stretch for a longer time. Banks will be having a fear. How can we borrow money from RBI?
Yes.
Because after 6 months, if the currency rate goes to 79 or 80, they have to pay 80, buy the dollar at 80 and give it to RBI at 75, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So the extra $5 will, 5 rupees will go from them against every dollar. So they will, instead of that, they'll go and buy it in the spot market because there they don't have to pay any money back.
Hmm.
Got it? Swap will work if you are expecting the mean reversion. That rupee will come back to 73, 74, then the swap will work. I can borrow from RBI today and repay after 6 months when the price comes to the same level. But after, if I'm expecting the price to go higher level after 6 months, then why will I borrow? I'll not borrow. Instead, I'll buy. Borrow in a sense, in a swap, you have to give one currency and take another currency. It's not like RBI is giving them a dollar denominated loan. RBI is giving them the dollar for temporarily to adjust it. Okay. Any questions?
And so in commodities, where should we go for the charts? CME groups only?
No, you can go to investing.com. Tell me which commodity you want.
That's all, gold and silver.
Okay. Are you in investing.com?
Investing it's all good. You will get all the details internationally.
See, types here. Gold if you type.
Okay.
Click on the commodities. So if they've written gold commodity COMEX, gold futures, that means it's CME gold.
CME, that is international market.
International market.
Okay.
Sir, this currency, whatever you thought, how different is it from crypto?
Crypto is totally different ball game, sir. Crypto, actually, see, crypto happens through OTC market. Basically, there is no, standard market where crypto, all cryptos are actively traded. So crypto ka prices varies from exchanges to exchanges. And moreover, Indians are not allowed to trade in crypto. It's illegal.
So I think now they have allowed, no?
Recently they
have. They've said, but you can't trade. You can't trade. How will you show the capital gains?
Okay, but some people keep on, some people say that we are miners, we are developers. I don't know what it is.
But my knowledge on crypto is very limited, sir. I'm very tired with USD INR only. I don't have extra time to think apart from USD INR and gold. This only takes around 6-7 hours of analysis, order execution, adjusting the trade. But one thing I'll tell you, most of the successful traders, they basically focus on one commodity or one asset class and they make money there. Typically, retail investors, they'll keep jumping from one commodity to another commodity wherever the price moves. Mm-hmm. Now, if you had kept on watching GBP, one killer move, you could have made a good fortune.
Yes.
37,000, if you had kept as a stop loss in your account, now you'll have 90,000. Mm. Correct?
Yes.
So, basically, like that, you have to keep focus on one currency or one commodity and make some money. Same thing with Nifty also. Just watch Nifty or Bank Nifty, whichever you're comfortable. Look at all the call options. See how you can do bull call, how you can do bear put. Look at strangle and then basically trade.
We did not do straddle.
Huh? Straddle is straddle. We had a discussion. It's very simple, sir. In strangle, what are you doing? You're selling one call and put, right?
Yes.
In straddle, you sell call and put of the same strike rate. For example, I'll do one straddle for USD INR and I'll show you. Very easy. So you have to sell a call, you have to sell a put. Correct? USD INR 75 call, March. Add. USD INR 75 put. So how much premium am I collecting here?
21.45.
Siddharth. Siddharth, are you there?
Yeah. I'm there.
How much?
Plus 22.
Okay, kitna collect kiya apne?
67.
67 you have collected. Now, if the USD INR closes at 75, what is your profit?
Both 6
or 7. Huh? Siddharth?
If the USD INR completes 75. So it is in the market, no? And the whole premium will be my profit only, no?
That is straddled here.
Okay.
When do you have loss?
When it goes more than this range.
Exactly. Or? You're selling 75 ka call, 75 ka put. Correct? So you're telling that and you're collecting 67 paisa. See. You're selling 75 call and 75 put. So you're telling if the market goes above 75, 67, you're in a loss.
Right.
Correct?
Right.
But you're missing an important point. You also have a loss. When is it?
When it goes.
When I do the put.
When it goes down below 74.
33.
You'll have a loss there. So when you should do this, Siddharth?
When there is a range.
When you expect the market to close at a certain point, you should do this. So currently for USD INR, you can't do it because like it can go to 77, 78. Okay. Probably for GBP, you could have done, but put options are not very liquid there. JPY, you can do it. Very good. Who was that? Anish? So basically short strangle should be done in sideways market. I've given you printout now. In that printout, if you see, I've given all the strategies also on the third sheet. The printout which we had given in SMI when the classes was conducted. In the third sheet, I've given all the strategies. There I mentioned do short strangle when you expect the market to be sideways. Until then, don't do it.
What do you normally do, sir?
I don't do anything apart from I do all the strategy based on the market condition.
Okay.
It's not like I'll do bull spread because I like it. Bull call spread, the market should be in a bullish mode.
Right.
Currently in USD INR, I'll do bear put spread. I'm more comfortable there. Because I know USD INR, see for example, if I take USD INR 74 put option. Okay, now I was very confident it will come down. I mean, USD INR will go up. So what I could have done around the year, March 6th, when the corona started become a big issue, I could have sold it. How much I would have got? I would have got 97 paise. I'm selling a put. When do I sell a put? Friends, when do you sell a put?
When it's in bullish.
Yeah, I'm expecting USD INR to go up. So basically from 74, I'm expecting it to go to 75. Correct?
Yes.
So I am selling a put. At what rate? At 74, says 80 paisa I'm selling, 90 paisa I'm selling it. Is there any risk for me?
No. Yes.
I have a risk, right? What if the market goes down? So to protect it, what I do, USD INR 73 ka put, I buy it. 73 put, I buy it. So if you see 73 put, that day, March 6th, it was trading at 25 paise. So I would have collected 95 paise on 74, paid 25 paise on 73. The difference, 70 paise was my profit. I sold 74 put.
And bought what?
73 put. Sell 74 put. So I'll collect 91 paise. Correct? I'll be collecting 91 paise. Buy 73 put. Pay 25 paise. The difference 66 paise. This is my profit. This profit will only come to me if USD INR remains above 74. But if USD INR had come to 73, my calculation went wrong. USD INR came to 73. Then here I had to pay 1 rupee back. I would have lost this 25 paise. I would have got zero here. So basically 9 paise loss there, 25 paise loss here. So overall, I would have made 34 paise loss. If I had succeeded, I would have got 66 paise. But the trend was telling me, na, it will not come down to 73. So blindly, I could have done it. Clear, friends? Any questions? Okay, so please follow all the charts, make notes, and we shall catch up during the live trade. So Nancy will decide on the live trade and she'll let you know. And all the links which you asked, I'll share it through WhatsApp. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
But three sheets, what you have said you have given during the class time, I don't think I received it, sir. Can you share it?
Yeah, I'll share it. I'll send you the PDF. You have to take a printout.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. Chalo, I'll send it. Whatever question is there, you send it through WhatsApp. I'll send it to you through that files. And I the notes you may notes you make note of it. And in the class, I will take a question. We are going to spend 6 hours on live trading. Na? So there I'll take it.
If in case live class is not there. No,
it should happen. Don't worry. Corona will not be there forever. Na?
Sir, I think government itself has declared till 31st no education institution.
Ah, correct. Work. Even it may go till April 15th. So if it goes April 15th or April 16th, we'll do it. Or we can do through online if you guys are comfortable.
No, sir. This will be better to do it in
live trading. If you guys want to do, we can do it in the online. Same, sharing the screen, taking question and doing it. You punch your order, I'll punch order here. Okay, so anyway, let's see. We'll wait till March 31st. So if they remove the restriction, we'll meet up in the class.
Yes, sir.
But I think it's better to stay indoors till 7th of April. This 14-day, we'll get to know who and all has got corona. Mm-hmm. And once they're all admitted in the hospital, the rest of them can come out. No, that's a simple solution. People are not understanding. 14, 15 days, if you... don't go out of the house and stay inside. The whole chain will stop. Yes. And after that, you can come work in the night, day, morning and basically recover it. Okay. So...
over today?
Huh?
Theory classes are getting over today?
No, I think that Nancy or George should be able to tell you, sir. I am not sure about your schedule.
No, we have that.
Hopefully, I have supported you well in your call put and currency and commodity. You should be able to start trading slowly. Your success in this market will totally depend how much time you spend on chart.
Sir, mutual fund, you will take it or somebody else will take it?
I think somebody else will take it, sir.
Balaji Rao,
sir, or Prasad Achaya will take it. So, Nancy and George will give you update on that, sir.
Okay.
Okay, so chalo friends, enjoy your rest of the weekend. Stay indoors. Okay, so inform all your friends about the advantages of being isolated. Once we are out of all this, we'll work hard. We'll work double and then we'll recover all the losses. Until then, let us take rest and give some good rest to our minds also. And this is a tough time to trade. Don't overload telling that tomorrow itself I have to make money. Even if you start trading well post June 1st, no problem. Spend a lot of time on analyzing the market.
Yes.
Okay. Chalo, sir. Thanks a lot. Take care. Bye.
Amen.
Bye.